Okay, can we all start? Right, class, can we start here? Yeah, can I start? Because I think six participants are there. Yeah. Sorry. Good evening, students. I welcome you all on behalf of MET Prep for the class of Maths of class 8. So we are just waiting for a few more minutes. So let us wait till 4:40 and then we will start our class. The topic for today will be our rational numbers. In the meantime, I'm just suggesting you all, please mute yourself. Any problem right now, you can just unmute and tell what is the problem coming to you so that we can help you out. Right? Anything, any sort of problem you can ask right now.
Hi, Tanya.
Hello.
Yes, Tanya, since it's the first class today, so let's wait for 5 minutes for the rest of the students to join in.
Right, ma'am. Okay. So can we start at 4:40?
Yeah.
Right. Okay, ma'am.
कौन है? अच्छा मुझे का पापा।
Please mute yourself, whoever is there. Bhavya Goyal.
Mom, I cannot see your video.
Okay, right now we are not showing the video.
Okay.
Yeah. So after 5 minutes, 4:45, I'll start with the class. Then I'll show you your things, right?
Okay.
Bhavya, you are in which class?
Class 8.
In which school?
St. Joseph's.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. Sorry. Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all on behalf of MET Prep. This is the class for class 8 math. And today we are going to start with a topic, rational number, which is the very first topic of that. But just before that, I just wanted to talk to you all. You all have done, how are you all liking math? Are you all liking math? I think no reply. Okay. So just before starting the chapter, I wanted to give you a few instructions before that, right? So let me start. Right. The chapter number is chapter 1, that is rational number. We are going to do it using our NCERT book. Few books also we have referred. But then I'll tell whenever the time starts, right? Okay, few instructions for all the students, whoever is there. Keep yourself on mute so that there is no disturbance. See, while we are studying, we should be focused on our work. So at that time, we should be on mute basis. After some time, when I'll give you the permission to give you to clarify your doubt, you are most welcome to unmute yourself and then ask your doubts. If any time you want to ask something else also, you can write in the chat box so that in the end I can check and then come back to you. Do not meddle with the PPT because it will be very difficult for me to handle at that time. As far as possible, please try to use your laptop, PC, Windows 10, as many features are not available on the smartphones. The student must leave the class when the session is over. Please do not use this platform for the personal conversations. Parents are requested to cooperate and keep a check on students' online activities, right? And one more thing related to the timing. See, if the class is at 4:30, I expect that you all can be there by 4:25 so that we can start our class on time and end on time, right? So let me just go ahead now. See, my first topic is rational number. See, whenever you are doing a rational number, we come to the fact that we have done many things beyond that. Like you are having some positive numbers. You were having fractions actually when you were doing in class 7. In class 7, you have done fractions, right? You have done fractions also, and in your term 2, you have done rational number also. There is a difference between both of them. When you do that, in fraction, we are taking a part of a whole, like 1 by 3 is a fraction, 4 by 5 is a fraction, 7 by 9 is a fraction. They all are fractions. You can write 9 by 2 also as a fraction, 4 by 7 also as a fraction. But then there is a difference between fraction and rational numbers. When you deal with fractions, you are having all positive. But when we are dealing with your rational numbers, because we are having the numbers of the form minus 3 by 7, 4 by 5, 9 by 10, your rational numbers are including your negative numbers also. In fractions, you are only having positive. But now when you come to your rational numbers, you are having negative numbers also. So you are having positive rational numbers, which is in the form 2 by 5 minus 3 upon minus 7. You are having negative rational numbers also, which is minus 2 by 5, 3 upon minus 7, minus 4 by 9, and so on. And you are having some standard form, which you already have done in your class 7. Going ahead. Yeah. So what topic we are going to cover in this session is your introduction to rational numbers, your properties of rational numbers, and rational number between two given rational numbers. So let me start with your very first topic, introduction to rational numbers. Coming to this part, See, when you all have started your education path, we all have told you about the counting numbers. But God has also given us the counting numbers, which are always available there in the environment. Like when you go out and you say how many biscuits you want 5 biscuits. They all are numbers, what we are creating here. So when we are having numbers, which are counting numbers, so we all have started with the natural numbers. The natural numbers are always starting with 1, 2, 3, so because they are counting numbers. We can't count negative. But yes, we can definitely count that how many fans are there, 2 fans are there, 4 fans are there. So they are called natural numbers. Now when I come to the whole number, so they gave an example, 4 minus 4. What is 4 minus 4? It came out to be 0. So they included 0 also. So when you have grown up, so you will ask 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. You are having this. Then came integers. Because you are not having negative numbers here, so integers clubbed it and it became 0, 1, 2, and so on your right hand side, and minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and so on your left hand side. Now, when we clubbed together, we came to the fractions and decimals. And fraction and decimal, when clubbed together, they all went into the rational numbers. So basically, the definition of rational number which we write is they are written in the form P upon Q. That is in the form of fraction, where P and Q both are integers. But Q is not equal to 0. I know that Q, 0 is also an integer, but we never keep the denominator as 0. Because if we keep this as 0, then it will become not defined. Because we have never done the numbers like that 4 by 0, minus 7 by 0, 8 by 0. So especially the condition for rational number is, it should be written in the form P by Q. Second, P and Q should be integers. And third, Q is not equal to 0. Some examples I'm giving it over here also. 8 by 9. So examples are 8 by 9. This is one example, 8 by 9, where 8 and 9 both are integers and your denominator is not equal to 0. Minus 4 upon 5, minus 4 and 5 both are integers and your denominator is not equal to 0. Similarly, minus 7 upon minus 8, again they both are integers and denominator is not equal to 0. 3 upon minus 4, again, both are integers and minus 4 is not equal to 0. Okay, few students are there. I think one of you can unmute yourself and tell any example from your side, if somebody can reply back. I'll wait for 30 seconds if somebody wants to reply back to any of the examples. Okay, let us go ahead. Okay, this is a question for you all. Which of the following is not a rational number? We are asking you which of the following is not a rational number. So let us check again. See, this is the first number, minus 3 upon 7. These both are integers and denominator is not equal to 0. So this is a rational number. Now I am having 2. Is 2 a rational number? I'm having 2, but in denominator, I don't have anything. So what to do? Can I write 2 as 2 by 1? Yes, we can write. And now, if I can have an observation, 2 by 1. 2 is also an integer, 1 is also an integer, and 1 is not equal to 0. So this is also a rational number. Coming to next one, minus 3 upon minus 7. Again, both are integers, and your denominator, which is minus 7, it is again not equal to 0. So this is also a rational number. Coming to 2.1. So 2.1, if I remove decimal sign, what do you get? If I remove this, I get below 10. So now if I can observe 21 upon 10. 21 and 10, both are integers. And your denominator is again not equal to 0. Therefore, this is also a rational number. Going ahead, 0.07. Can I again remove a decimal? I can again remove. See, why I am removing them? Because 0.07 upon 1, if I take 0.07 is not an integer, it's a decimal number. So first I have to remove my decimal, and when I remove, I get 7 upon 100. Now 7 is also an integer, 100 is also an integer. So 7 upon 100 is also a rational number, which implies there is not even a single number which is not a rational number. All are coming under the category of rational numbers. Right. So when we are dealing in class 7, there were few properties of integers, fractions and decimals. So today we are going to discuss among the properties of the rational number and based on that particular thing. So you know why we are doing the properties of rational number? Why we are doing them? See, like I give an example to you all. Like if I want to do 14 into 15, I feel it very difficult to do it. But then if I apply my trick, 14 into 10 is 140, 14 into 5 is 70. And immediately I can do 140 plus 70, that is 210. So basically few properties are there to make your calculation easy for yourself. But obviously you have to observe what you are doing. You have to analyze your situation. What type of property I can apply? Now, if I'm having 14 into 15, I can do 14 into 10 plus 5. I can do 14 into 12 plus 3. My wish. Things are in my hand. Like 14 into 15, I'm not able to do, but I'm able to do 15 into 14. I do it very quickly, 15 into 14. So coming based on all these properties, properties are actually helping us to do our calculation faster. We can observe them and we can use it in our calculation. Because these are the things by which you can score marks, because the calculation work is that thing which we all have to master. In 10th class, like we are doing the concepts, and at that time, we are not very fast in calculation. We all will be very, very slow at that time, and then we will lose marks. So right now, we have to increase our calculation speed. And for increasing our calculation speed, we should definitely look into how to make our calculations easier for us. How can we do them very quickly? And it should not take so much of time to do it. We should observe and we should definitely use them in our condition. So coming to your very first condition, closure property. So under this closure property, closure says when two numbers are rational numbers, what happens when they are added? What happens when they are subtracted? What happens when they multiply? Are they again a rational number? Closure is taking all the numbers inside. So let me see the first one, closure property. Yeah, this is, see, rational numbers are closed under addition, which we say. Let us take two examples to justify our statement. I took two numbers, 11 by 3 and 4 by 3. They both were rational numbers. And when I added them, I took the LCM 3, calculation wise, when I simplified it, it became 15 by 3, which is coming out to be 5. Is 5 a rational number? Because 5 can be written as 5 by 1. So 5 and 1 both are integers and 1 is not equal to 0. Therefore, 5 is a rational number. Similarly, I have taken one more. 8 and 3 both were rational numbers. When I added them, it became 11, which is again a rational number. So rational numbers are closed under addition. Let us take the same thing for multiplication also. I took two numbers, 11 by 3 and 4 by 3 again. So when I multiply both of them, 11 into 4 was 44, 3 into 3 was 9. And when I multiplied, I got 44 by 9. This is again a rational number. Now let us justify our statements. Is it true for my subtraction also? So let us have a look. So when I took subtraction, I'm again taking two numbers, 11 by 3 minus 14 by 3. When I did the calculation, it is coming out to be minus 3 by 3. And in the simplification form, I was getting minus 1. Minus 1 is again a rational number. Let us take one more if you can. 5 minus 5 by 4. And if I do it, 5 minus 5 by 4, what will be the LCM of this? Or if I want to simplify in my way, it will be 20 minus 5. I'm taking the LCM, so it will be 20 minus 5. 12 upon 4. So the answer comes out to be 15 by 4. You can take any example, any number, whatever number you take, want to take it in the form. But anytime, whenever you will subtract or add or multiply, you will get again the rational number. Coming to the next, what happens to the rational number closed on the division? Is it true or not? Let me check. Coming to the division, rational numbers, first let us see the example for this. Rational numbers are not closed on the division. Why? See, because division by zero is not defined. Let me see an example. See, we have given an example over here. 6 divided by 0. See, 6 was a rational number. 0 is also a rational number. But when I divide, I get 6 upon 0. And we can't get in the denominator as 0. So therefore, this is not a rational number. That is why we are using the word not defined. And that's why it is not closed under division. Going on to the next. So basically, in closure property, it holds for addition, subtraction, and multiplication. But it is not holding for division. Next one. Commutative property. The commutative property says, this is actually very, very helpful to you all while doing your calculations. Like I am doing, if somebody gives me the number, multiply 2 into 24. It's very big for me. My God, how to multiply 2 into 24? But yes, I know how to do 24 into 2 very fast. So 24 into 2 will become 48. So commutative property says that either you multiply 2 into 24 or you multiply 24 into 2. It doesn't matter. If you want to add two numbers, like you are adding 15 plus 10. Or you add 10 plus 15. Does it matter? No, because the answer comes out to be same. But let me see for subtraction. If I'm having 7 minus 4, I think the answer for 7 minus 4 is 3. And coming over here, 4 minus 7. I'm doing the vice versa now. Can we see that? Minus 3. So, it is not holding for subtraction. Again, we can see for division also. 7 divided by 4, you get 7 by 4. And 4 divided by 7, you get 4 upon 7. Again, they are not equal. So it means, in generalized form, if we can say, commutative property is holding for addition and multiplication. But it is not true for your subtraction and division. So whenever you are having problem in your addition and multiplication, you can take the help of commutative property. But do not take the help of this property while addition, sorry, subtraction and division, because this is not holding true for them. Let us go ahead over here. So see, they are giving an example again. Minus 3 by 8 plus 1 by 7 I took, and 1 by 7 plus minus 3 by 8. I just put a line over here. Yeah. So this is my, when I add, the LCM of 8 and 7 is 56. And the equivalent fraction for this minus 3 by 8 will be minus 21 by 56 and 8 by 56. So when I finally add them and simplify, it becomes minus 13 by 56. Similarly, when I add the vice versa, it is again giving me minus 13 by 56. So which implies this is holding true for addition. Yes, see, we have taken an example for subtraction also. Minus 3 by 7 minus 1 by 7. If I get the answer, it is coming out to be minus 4 by 7. But if I see over here, minus 1 by 7 minus minus plus, plus 3 by 7, the answer is coming out to be 2 by 7. So they are not equal. It means this is not holding true for your commutative property under addition. Coming to the multiplication, A into B is same as B into A, which we have discussed earlier. We have just given an example there. Okay, associative property. See, sometimes you are getting very big numbers and you just have to multiply or add. But then we try to observe which one is a very easy one to be added or which one is very easy to be multiplied. Like if I can give one example over here. You are having 2 into 15 into 5. So which one is the best to multiply first? 2 into 5. Very quickly we can multiply. 2 into 5 will be 10. And 10 into 15 will become 150. So this is the easiest way. Associative also says the same thing. You can multiply these two first, or these two first, or these two first. And afterward, you can multiply with the remaining one. It doesn't matter. So over here, example, addition is associative for rational number. If you all can observe an example, 2 plus 5 plus 3. If I do this way, again, I'm getting an answer to be 8, 10. Or if I do 2 plus 5 plus 3, again, I get the same answer as 10. Multiplication is associative for rational numbers. Yeah, this is holding for associative also, because you can multiply any two numbers depending on your requirement. If you want that the things to be very good, then you have to observe which property is making my calculation easier for all of us. Coming to next, division part. Okay, coming to the additive inverse. See, whenever we have inverse, inverse means opposite. If I can come to your English line, inverse means opposite. And what is the opposite of addition? Opposite of addition is negative. This is plus. So it means the meaning of additive inverse is negative of any number, because the inverse of addition is negative and inverse of subtraction is positive. So coming over here, your additive inverse is negative of a number. So here it is, if you are having a by b, the additive inverse is minus a by b. If you are having minus a by b, the additive inverse will become a by b. And if I add both of them, number added to its inverse, I get 0. So additive inverse is that number which is the negative of a number. Coming to the next slide. Okay, very quickly, let us all do the additive inverse of these numbers. Okay, what is the additive inverse of 2 by 8? Can anyone tell what is the additive inverse of 2 by 8? Okay, the additive inverse of 2 by 8 is minus 2 by 8. Negative of our number. Okay, coming to next, minus 5 by 9. What is the additive inverse? Negative number it is there, so I will take positive. So 5 by 9. Since the number is positive, so it is not compulsory for us to write plus sign over there. We can skip if we want. Next, minus 6 upon minus 5. First, you just simplify them, because there are two negative signs which we can simplify. So minus into minus divided by minus is plus. So you are having the number 6 by 5. So what is the additive inverse of 6 by 5? It is minus 6 upon 5. Coming to next, 2 upon minus 9. What is the additive inverse of this? You are having a negative sign in the denominator. It's better to keep the denominator negative sign in numerator always. So the additive inverse of this will become minus 2 by 9. No, the additive inverse of this will become plus 2 by 9. Similarly, what is the additive inverse of this? So it will become plus 19 upon 6. See, I'm not doing the reciprocal of a number. I'm just removing the negative sign if it is positive. And if it is negative, I'm just removing the negative sign and make it positive. Additive inverse only says negative of a number. Continuing ahead, multiplicative inverse. See, now what we have done right now, inverse is opposite. And opposite of addition was negative. So over here, multiplicative inverse. So what is the inverse of multiplication? It is divide. The inverse of the multiplication is divide. So if I'm having 4 by 5, so what will be the multiplicative inverse? So basically, the multiplicative of this number will be reciprocal of a number which is used for division. So the reciprocal of 4 by 5 will become 5 by 4. Going on next, Multiplicative inverse is also known as reciprocal of a number. So let us see, when we multiply the number with its reciprocal, what do you get? A by B, when multiplied by B by A, we get 1. So multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 7 will be, just do the reciprocal, no need to change the sign. The sign will be as it is. So the multiplicative inverse of minus 3 by 7 will become 7 upon minus 3. It is in your favor if you want to write it minus 7 by 3, or you can write 7 upon minus 3. It doesn't matter. But yes, if you want to keep the answer in standard form, minus 7 by 3 is the preferred one. Next one. Okay, coming to your question. These are few questions which are there in NCERT. So if you want to refer your NCERT, you can refer also, right? Find the multiplicative inverse of minus 13. So what is it? Minus will be as it is. 13 by 1 is a number. So what is the reciprocal of that? Opposite. Reciprocal. Just vice versa. Minus 13 by 19, it will become minus 19 by 13. What is the reciprocal of 1 by 5? The answer is 5. What is the reciprocal of this number? Oh my God, shall I write minus 8 by 5 into minus 7 by 3? No. First, simplify them. The answer for this particular question will be 15 by 56. And now, when you take the multiplicative inverse, the answer will become 56 upon 15. Next, coming to this one, minus 1 into minus 2 by 5. First, simplify them, so it will become 2 by 5. And when I do the reciprocal of this number, it will become 5 by 2. Coming ahead, minus 1. The reciprocal of minus 1 will be, see, you are having below, you are having 1. So the reciprocal will be minus 1 upon 1. But again, it is the same thing, so minus 1. Now with this, can you tell me what is the reciprocal of 1? So the reciprocal of 1 will be, reciprocal of 1 will be 1, and reciprocal of minus 1 will be minus 1. There is no change, because if I do the reciprocal also, 1 is there only. Coming to next, additive identity. This we have to see first. What number should be added in 4 by 5? What number should be added to get 4 by 5 back? This is 0. So, 0 is the additive identity. Identity says which is giving the same number back to us. So, 0 is the additive identity. And similarly, for multiplicative identity, we are 1, because 4 by 5 or 9 by 7 or 8 by 9, whatever the rational number you take, if I multiply it by 1, I am getting the same number back, 9 upon 7. So over here, if you have understood the property, let me try. What name the property under multiplication used in the following? See, they are already mentioning that it is your multiplication. Now, what is the property used here? Minus 4 by 5 into 1. 1 into minus 4 by 5. And you are getting 4 by minus 4 by 5. See, there are now, again, this is commutative property also. This is multiplicative identity also. So you can write anything, right? Coming to next thing, it will be a commutative property, or you can write edit multiplicative identity, because we are using that line also. We are multiplying it with 1. Now coming to next, minus 13 by 17 into minus 2 by 7 and minus 2 by 7 into minus 13 by 17. What type of property it is? A into B, B into A. Okay, so this is commutative property. Now what will you suggest for this property? Minus 19 by 29 and 29 by minus 19, which is equal to 1. So what will I write? What type of property we are using? So this property is multiplicative inverse, because I am multiplying the number with its reciprocal and getting the answer as 1. So it is multiplicative inverse. Going ahead with your next question. Okay, these are NCERT questions which we have tried to do it for you all. They are saying multiply 6 by 13 by the reciprocal of minus 7 by 16. See, my dear, when you are reading the questions in mathematics, you just have to follow some steps. And step by step, if you will do it, you will get your own answers. You will not be having so many confusions. So if I can just see, I'm having two steps here. Multiply 6 by 13 by the reciprocal of minus 7 by 16. So my very first step is to make the reciprocal of minus 7 by 16. So I have to taken my first step as reciprocal of minus 7 by 16 is 16 upon minus 7. I prefer to keep negative up, so I'm just keeping it up as a standard form also. And now second step, multiply 6 by 13 by minus 16 by 7. So this is my second step. So follow your steps slowly and slowly. You will get your answer very quickly. So it will be 6 into minus 16, which is minus 96, and 13 into 7, which is coming out to be 91. So the final answer for this question is multiply 6 by 13 by the reciprocal of minus 7 by 16 will become minus 96 upon 91. Okay, again a property here. Tell what property you are using to compute. You are having three numbers, 1 by 3 into 6 into 4 by 3. Okay, and now you are doing 1 by 3 into 6 into 4 by 3. This is actually the associative property of multiplication. Going ahead with another question there. Is 8 by 9 the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 by 8? See, according to my question, the 8 by 9 multiplicative inverse should be 9 by 8. But it is not there. So let us see first. But this is in mixed fraction. So my very first step is to convert this into improper fraction. So I am converting it first. Minus 1, 1 by 8. If I just cross check, 8, I am just leaving my minus as it is. No change. Whenever I convert my mixed fraction into improper fraction, my minus will be there only. It will not change and it will not go anywhere. It will be there only. So let us multiply 8 into 1. It is 8. 8 plus 1, 9. So the answer is minus 9 by 8. Now let us see. According to the requirement, the multiplicative inverse, I'll find out. What is the multiplicative inverse of minus 9 by 8? It should be the reciprocal. So the reciprocal will come out to be minus 8 by 9. We are not changing the negative sign. So when we are not changing the negative sign, it will become the multiplicative inverse of minus 9 by 8 is minus 8 by 9. But in question, it is writing 8 by 9. So it means it is not. So 8 by 9 is not the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 by 8. Minus 1, 1 by 8. Final answer should be what the question is asking you, not what you are getting. Every time, just check what is the question and what they want from you. They want that is 8 by 9 the multiplicative inverse of this or not. So just give them the answer that 8 by 9 is not the multiplicative inverse of minus 8 by 9. That's all. Coming to the next one. Is 0.3 the multiplicative inverse of 3 1 by 3? Okay, again see, this is 0.3 and this is 3 1 by 3. So very first step, convert it into your mixed fraction to improper fraction. So I have converted it. It becomes 10 by 3. Now 10 by 3 is there. Okay. Now, what is the multiplicative inverse of 10 by 3? It is a reciprocal, so multiplicative inverse of 10 by 3 will become 3 by 10. Okay, and now coming to 0.3. 0.3, if I remove decimal, what I get? I get 3 by 10. So can I write 3 by 10 is the multiplicative inverse of 10 by 3? Yes. So which implies 0.3 is a multiplicative inverse of 3 1 by 3. Coming to the next one. Okay, finally we have done so many properties. I'm confused. So let me just sort it out again. So when we have done, very first property we were doing, rational numbers are closed under the operations addition, subtraction and multiplication. Under which property it is not holding? It is not holding under division. Because whenever you are having 6 divided by 0 or 7 divided by 0, it is not defined. It is not a rational number because 6 and 0 were rational numbers, but 6 divided by 0 when we have done, it is not a rational number. Coming to next one, The operations addition and multiplication, they are commutative also, they are associative also. But the two things are not holding for subtraction and division. It is only holding for addition and multiplication. Going on to the next one, the rational number 0 is the additive identity for all rational numbers. It says when this 0 is added to any number, you will get the same number back. Coming to the next one, the rational number 1 is a multiplicative identity for rational numbers. If I multiply any number with 1, any number, you get the same number back. That is why 1 and 0 are additive identity and multiplicative identity. Going ahead, additive inverse. What was additive inverse? It was negative of a number. So if you have a by b, I will write minus a by b. If you have 4 by 3, I will write minus 3 by b. Sorry. What am I writing? Additive inverse. Yeah, so 4 by 3 additive inverse will be minus 4 by 3. If I'm having minus 7 by 9, the additive inverse will be 7 by 9. Just you have to remove the negative sign to make it the additive inverse. And if you have a positive number, just write a negative so that it becomes the additive inverse of that number. Going ahead, this reciprocal, which is the synonym for multiplicative inverse of the rational number, a by b, it will be the reciprocal of that number. So a by b is b by a. So the multiplicative inverse of a by b will become b by a. Okay, one more thing what we have to plan to do. How many rational numbers are there between two rational numbers? I can get so many rational numbers between them. So they are infinite. If it is there, I'll just definitely show. So please try these two questions. Exercise 1.1. I have already covered all. And try to do your question number 10 and 11. See, till the time you will not do your questions, you will not try, you will not be able to solve out your problems only. So it's better, you should try to solve your problems. Like over here, I'm having one particular question using a rearrangement. Rearrangement means using a suitable property for this particular question. So if I observe, I'm having first term, second term, third term. Which is easier for me to add? If I can see here, oh yes, in denominator, I'm getting 4. So it is easier for me to add. So minus 3 by 4 plus 1 by 4. It is very easy for me to add. So when I add, it will become minus 2 by 4. Wow. See, so easy. Now going ahead. But this is left out. Plus 7 by 8 is left out. So I'm trying to apply which property over here? This is my associative property. Now 2 by 4 I can simplify also if I want. So it will be minus 1 by 2 plus 7 by 8. Oh yes, I have to take the LCM of both of them. So for that, I'll take the LCM as 8, so 2 into 4 and use the equivalent fractions. Minus 4 plus 7. So it will become 3 upon 8. Very good. See the calculation. See, these are all your tricks. So you all have to apply your own tricks so that you are able to apply them. Coming to the second part over here. See, I am again observing which is best for me. If I have to use associative, yes. I think these two are best for me. 1 by 7 minus 3 by 7. So let us do these two first. I don't have to take actually the equivalent numbers over here. So it will become minus 2 by 7. See, so fast. Minus 1 by 6, minus 5 by 6. Hurry up. No need to do so many of calculations because the denominator is same as for both of them. So it is minus 1. And minus 2 by 7, minus 1 will become minus 9 by 7. See how I am taking the help of all my properties to do my calculation. It's so easy, but yes, we should understand the properties very nicely so that the things are getting onto our own thing. Okay, going ahead. Well, that's all for today. Like now, I'll come to my questions, what I'm having. Yeah. So any doubt right now? So anyone can unmute and please ask if you have any doubt. Any doubt? Anyone having any doubt? You can unmute yourself and ask. Now is the time to ask. Anyone? You can unmute yourself and ask so that I can go ahead. I'm waiting for 2 minutes. If anybody want to ask anything, any query, please ask. No, ma'am. Fine, Devang Sai. Very good. Okay. Okay. Good. Anyone else? No one? Okay. So going ahead. Yes. Somebody? Yes. Bhavya Goyal? Yes. You want to ask something? Please unmute yourself and ask. Bhavya Goyal, yes. Any doubt, anything, anybody want to ask? No one? Okay. So I'll go ahead if you have not asked any doubts. So I'm giving few questions for your practice if you want to practice. So any problem, anything, any query, anyone who want to ask anything can ask right now. Then I'll come to the questions. No one? Okay, going ahead with the things then. These are few practice questions which I'm opening. Today we have done your rational numbers, your properties, and under properties we have done. Okay, see, these are the few terms which we are using here. Right. See, the first question we have done over here, minus 3 by 4 plus 7 by 8. Now, coming to this property, see over here, you are having 5 by 9 into minus 4 by 5 plus, yeah, any problem to anyone? Yeah, Bhavya Goyal? Okay, fine. Okay, coming back to it, now you are having my first one. Five by nine into minus 4 by 5, and you have plus minus 4 by 5 into 2 by 3. See, it's very tedious to do this one. So how to go about this property? I prefer that we can take something common, but this is, I think, based on your just wait. I redo it. Right. Is it visible now? Yes. Coming to this one first. You are having 32 by 5 plus 23 by 11 into 22 by 15. What is the best way to solve? I'm just trying to solve it in the best way. Okay. If I can see my best way of doing, I am not able to apply any property. No. Yes. See? 11 and 22, they are getting cancelled, if you all can see. Over here, you are having this. You can straight away cancel 11 and 22. When I cancel both of them, Not coming. Right. So over here, what I'm doing here? I think it's visible now. I can cancel these two numbers over here, 22 and 11. When I cancel them, it becomes 2 and 11 is gone. 11 is gone over here. So what we are left with, 32 by 5 plus 23 into 2. What the answer will be? 46. So it will become 46 by 15. If I can write over here, I'll start writing also. Yeah. So coming over here, what I can do, insert. And if I'm not getting 32 by 5 plus 46 by 15. Now I'm not having the same denominator. So I have to change my 5 to 15. So for that, I multiply both of them with 3. So it will become 96 upon 15 plus 46 upon 15. So when I add 96 and 46, I get 142 by 15. But since I have to get my answer in a simpler form, I can get my answer in the mixed fraction form, which comes out to be 97 by 15 will be the correct answer. So I can just write if I can. Okay, coming to the next one, if I can solve this one, 3 by 7 into 28 by 15 divide by this. See, how to make my divide as multiply? Take the reciprocal of the number. See, this is all simplification where you, if you can use your properties, try to use them so that you can get your perfect answers and you can get your things very easily. See, your properties, again I'm telling, it is there to make your calculation easy. And it can be provided you all try to observe the small part into it. Like if I can observe small things, I can make it very easily into. It is 5 by 14. And now if I can see 14 and 28 are cancelling, it is coming out to be 2. And over here, 5 and 15, if I cancel when I'm doing it, 3. So I'm getting 2 by 3. Oh, again, this 2 is cancelling, 3 is cancelling with this. So my final answer, I think it's coming out to be 2 by 7. You just have to observe your things. As much as you all will observe, you will come to know your things very nicely. Coming to this one, it is having plus, but we can't do plus because Bodma says multiply first. Okay, can I simplify this little bit? Yes, minus 2 into minus 5. Or I can take the LCM, sorry, cross also, it will be 5 upon 21 into 3, it will be 63. So 3 by 7 plus 5 upon 63. Again, I can take the LCM very easily. So 3 by 7 and 5 by 63. What will be the LCM? 63. But then I have to change my 9. So it will be 27 plus 5, that is 32 upon 63. So the answer for this particular question will come out to be 32 upon 63. Coming to this, oh my God, they are having both the things, plus and minus. So which one is easy for us to do? 8 and 12? No. I think 8 and 16 is a better one because it's easy for us to manage it. So the LCM of 8 and 16 will come out to be, I think, 16. So 8 into 2 and 7 into 2. So the answer will be 15 upon 16. But now there is no way to simplify our thing. We have to take the LCM of 12 and 16. There is no other way. So let us take the LCM and it will be 152. And when it is 152, now how to solve them? Anyone can try? No one? Try somebody? Okay, any other LCM which you want to take, because I have taken the LCM like this. So how to take the LCM? No one? So LCM is 48. And when the LCM is 48, so it will be 45 minus 4. So the answer will come out to be 41 upon 48. So any other query, anything you want to ask? Anyone who want to ask anything? Any problem, anything? Yes, cannot see screen. Okay. Any problem, anyone? Because I have done the entire session with the rational number. I want you to ask anything because there must be few doubts in your mind related to your properties. Anything, anyone, don't hesitate and just ask. Unmute yourself and ask. Devanshi Sai, Ajit Chauhan, Bhavya Goyan, anyone, ma'am, why didn't we take the before number 1 centimeter? Because numbers, you can take any number, Devanshi. There is no problem at all. You can take any number. You just try to solve the numbers with any questions, you will be able to get it. It was by chance I have taken one number. You can take anything. Anybody else? In chat also you can write so that I can continue ahead.
Be prepared for your next class and join the next class that is scheduled as मतलब उनको जो भी schedule है ना उसके according next class join करना ये बोलते हैं आप find करोगे.
So now I am ending with the session. The topic is over. Kindly revise your work. Whatever the problem you have, please take a note of them and ask in your next class. So let us meet